بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. This is the khutbah al-haja which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم would begin with as a reminder to the companions that what is to come is serious, and for them to be attentive and to listen carefully for the advice. So following the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, we begin with khutbah al-haja. And this is something that one of the mashayikh in this century, rahimahullah, Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani rahimahullah, strive to revive this sunnah, such that he has a risala, a small treatise on khutbah al-haja, and he has defended it as being sunnah, not just for beginning a marriage ceremony, but actually for starting a khutbah, such that praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم would do whenever he would begin his sermons or begin his lectures. And the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that any statement or any speech that, you know, is not preceded with alhamd, then it is cut off or it is deficient. So we should begin with alhamd. And as for the hadith, any hadith that doesn't begin with bismillah, then it is cut off, then that narration is not authentic. And you can find it, there's a nice book out which is an explanation of Usul al-Thalatha called Husul al-Ma'mul, Sharh Thalathati al-Usul. And in the beginning he gives you the references for why that hadith is da'if and so on. And he refers to the books of Shaykh Nasir rahimahullah. So you can find it there. Today, inshallah, what we hope to, inshallah, begin, what we hope to talk about is really, you know, first and foremost, respecting the scholars and knowing the scholars. And from them, we wanted to look at Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahab Marzuq al-Banna, one of the scholars in Mecca, and he also resides in Jeddah, where he has his own masjid there. So today, inshallah, we wanted to look into this alim al-Rabbani, this blessed scholar who is not only a alim in, you know, through his knowledge, but also by his actions and his mannerisms. So inshallah, we'll begin by first and foremost looking at the Ahl al-Hadith, the scholars of Ahl al-Hadith. Khatib al-Baghdadi rahimahullah, he mentioned in Sharf Ashab al-Hadith number 153 from a trustworthy Imam Qutaybah ibn Sa'id, he said, if you see a man loving Ahl Hadith, like Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, and Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi, and Ahmed ibn Hanbal, and Ishaq ibn Rahawiyah, and he mentioned other people, then know that he is upon the Sunnah. And whoever differs from this, then know that he is an innovator. So our love for Ahl Hadith, and primarily the scholars of Ahl Hadith, this is a sign of the Sunnah, sign that the person is muwaffaq, a sign that a person is upon the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And hatred for Ahl al-Hadith, know that this is a sign for sign of the innovators. And if you look at Sharh al-Sunnah of Imam Barbahari, there's a narration there where he quotes, I think it's Fudayl ibn Iyad, where he says, if you want to recognize the sign of Ahl al-Sunnah is that they make dua for the rulers, and if you want to recognize the sign of Ahl al-Bid'ah, they speak ill of the rulers. So these are some of the signs that Ahl al-Hadith, Ahl al-Sunnah have mentioned in the past, How to recognize who are Ahl Sunnah? They love the Ahl Hadith, they love the scholars of Ahl Hadith, and they try to follow them and emulate them in their actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed the Ahl al-Ilm. First and foremost, He has blessed them with Tawheed, such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after He has bore witness of Himself being one in worship, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself, He bore witness to His oneness. شهد الله, Allah bears witness, أنه لا إله إلا هو, that there's none worthy of being worshipped except Him. شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة, and also the angels bear witness, those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are commanded and they fulfill the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thereafter He said, وَأُولُ الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. The scholars, the أُولُ الْعِلْمِ, are the possessors of knowledge. They're the ones that testify to Allah's oneness. They're the ones who know and carry the flag of Tawheed, the banner of Tawheed, the banner of لا إله إلا الله, لا معبود بحق إلا الله, that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. If you ask many people, what is the meaning of لا إله إلا الله, they would not know. Being Muslims, they will not know. They maybe say there's no God but God, or no God but Allah. That is deficient. Or they may say, no God worthy of worship except Allah. Even that is deficient. No God, no deity has the right to be worshipped. The word bilhaq is very important, as Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah says. لا معبود بحق إلا الله. It's not sufficient to say لا معبود إلا الله. There's no worship, none is worshipped except Allah, because there are many deities that are worshipped besides Allah. People worship money, people worship women, people worship idols, people worship many things. Lakin bilhaq, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the right to be worshipped. And those who stand by this kalima at-tawheed, at the forefront of them are the scholars, the Ahl al-Ilm. Qa'iman bilqist, they are upright with this kalima, la ilaha illallah. Whereas if you look at many of the misguided people, even amongst the Muslims, some of those who call to Islam but a distorted form of Islam, you find they don't even understand the kalima. So if they have failed to understand even the kalima, then how about the rest of the deen? How are you going to establish Islam if you don't even know how to establish the kalima to tawheed, which is the first rukun, the first pillar in Islam? Shahid Allah, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse, he said to us that these are the ones who bear witness to his kalima, to his tawheed. First and foremost, Allah testifies to Himself to be one in worship. شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the أهل العلم. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. Allah raises, يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ. Allah will raise amongst those who believe and those who have been given knowledge many levels. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ. So He raises amongst those who believe. From amongst the believers, mashallah, you find those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised in terms of their iman, you know, their salawat. Allah opens the door for salah, for example, for them, such that they are always in a masjid. They have been enlightened to you know, for that door of salah to be open for them. Another type of Muslim, you find that maybe he has been enlightened towards knowledge. Another one, he has been enlightened towards fasting regularly. But at the heads of them are the Ahlul Ilm. You find that they are enlightened in many of these actions of worship. Many of these actions of worship. So when you ask who is fasting, the time the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he asked who is fasting, Abu Bakr said, Ana. Who is, and I can't remember the rest of the narration, but he mentioned various aspects of worship. He said, Ana, Ana, every time, Ana, Ana, Ana. This is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu anhu. Worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not just a matter of data, just a matter of speaking. It was a matter of ibadah, a matter of ibadah. And ibadah, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he said, al-ibadatu ismun jami'. It's a comprehensive terminology. لكل ما يحبه الله ويرضى. To everything that Allah loves and is pleased with. من الأقوال والأعمال الظاهرة والباطنة.